Hey everyone, this is Holden Rise of Weird, and in this one I'm gonna do the 6th standalone mission. I do still have some Cyberstorm stuff to uploading at the moment, and as for the Max stuff, I'll be uploading this into hour parts, just to make it easier to digest. I just did a practice run of this, and this mission is not that fun already. So, it is definitely, you don't have any scouting components or defensive work, so you have no scan already to start with. Your opponent has scan, and has more, generally better range units than you do. This kind of reminds me of that one mission, there's one Command & Conquer mission where you're like surrounded by enough tanks to destroy your base outright, but apparently they were completely stupid or something like that. I don't know why. It was weird. So it says I can get a power station working, which I probably need to do earlier than I tried last time. You know, you get a power station, you're getting another one. So the whole point is to survive so reinforcements can get made. And they really don't give you much. They really don't. Actually, that mining station has some gold, but this only had like 4 and 3, so you might not need to connect this right off, because it's not going to do much for you. I might have to just connect up here, because these one had more resources than pretty much anything down here. Just gonna build this right off. I'm thinking of, I want to get the engineer first, but I need scouts so I can at least see what I'm shooting at. But this also makes another problem is that do you delay the engineer, because they'll get to a fairly important choke point like 3 turns in. So right here. Like, they can shoot right here about 3 turns in. So, I want to try to get my mine layer up there as soon as possible. And just get stuff up there. Because I'm going to need stuff up there. And I know they'll start shooting at it, but I need those mines down, so at least I have some defensive perimeter. Right here is fine. You're going up here because they have the range units up that way more. Alright. 8 turns should be okay. I'm gonna get the scouts first. And I don't know, I guess this is just my gripe with just level's game design, but I don't understand who makes spaces like this. Here's all the buildings, but we're not gonna connect anything. I guess that's the point of the challenge, but that'd be like setting up a town full of 20 people and then not having any food. Boy, it's weird. And I know the scouts probably won't hit the mines because that's going to be expected. But I need to hold back a decent way and space my units out so the rocket launchers aren't shooting them all day, all along. That'll work. Not really, but it'll be enough. And down here, they mostly use the Musashi tanks. So green is down here, and blue is up here. I'm pretty sure blue is Ayers' hand. So you need to keep back until you can see them, otherwise they'll just use their range and scanners and kill you. Because they'll just outrange all your units and you can't see where it's coming from. It's kind of frustrating. As we'll see in the 10-turn practice run, which I think lasted about 10 minutes. Might have been half an hour. I don't know, I haven't checked the video record time yet. Like, I just recorded that one and then went to this one. Because it was like, alright, that run was terrible. You know, let's, you know, let's do it better this time. Because I need to reach 50 Ecosphere rating. Or no, be the first person to reach 50 Ecosphere rating. So I'm assuming they probably only have one constructor or something. And an engineer, maybe. And if they wanted to, they could do it now with the force they have. Alright, so this one's a terrible mining station. No, that was a good one, sorry. It was this one that was like 4 and 3. But I may as well survey it anyway. Alright, so scouts available. Oh, I could have upgraded. Shit, I probably should have upgraded it. Fuck. I don't have any. Feel like I want to save my gold for something better, though, so that's why I'm not touching it right now. Oh, I do have a forward tip right here. Be careful about using your rocket launchers near mine lines because they will destroy your own mines. So if you really need to, put them back just enough to where they're not going to gun down your own mines. I got to explore here right now. Let's take that out. I'm going to leave that right here, actually, right, just kind of like. I don't want to hit the mine, so I'm trying to move it. Everyone back up. You might need to go right there. That'll work. Okay, yeah, that'll work. So, some of these might look really weird, but it'll make sense. Trust me. Just put you there, you here. I mean, it is Musashi tanks, so you really need to just have a decent line so they don't get through. Oh, here they come. Yeah, so 3 turns. And they're already at your doorstep from every direction, pretty much. So you might even be able to bring the mine line just right here instead of right here. Although they haven't fired yet, which is concerning me. It happened last time, because I had my mine layer too far out. So I don't know what's stopping them this time. See, I could fire right here, but I don't want to kill this whole line just because of that one tank. So I'm going to put it over here where it can actually. Yeah, shoot. That did 4 damage. Okay, so the tanks are once again serving the role of meat shield. So if you saw my video on the wall, you know what I mean by that when I say that term like that? I feel like I need to have a tank get shot first so I can move my scan in safely. So once we build the scout, the engineer's just gonna go up and then just keep going up that way. And then I'll have the other engineer start taking down here. So right now. And then bail. Alright, there it comes. Take a shoot at that. Also, how powerful are those scouts? Oh, okay, normal. Like, there's just 8 armor. Alright, so they're firing from this direction. Oh, they're just up there. I'm gonna try to branch out here. Of course, I can't hit it because the Sacrologists are a good unit, but at the same time, they're pretty flawed. It's like it's a siege you have to set up. Kind of like trebuchets. But, you know, Age of Empires does have different mechanics. I might need to back you up because I know they have more rocket launchers. They won't bring just one. It's Ayer's Hand. So if I can see at least enough right here, then I can have the missile crawler play defense. That might be the best shot it has. Let's go back here, or no, over here. Not seeing anything from a distance. I might take one more shot, but I'm gonna try to use the tanks to take care of the scouts. Because they can't dent the tanks at all. I think I'm more worried about blue than I am about green. Just because of the Sashi tanks, you can kind of whittle down from a distance. That's pretty much your best defense. But blue has the range to. I mean, they've got missile crawlers. There's no way that they just have rocket launchers. That is going to be a problem. And I know, I think they see this here. So they know they can just keep doing that. So I might send the assault gun up here instead. Okay, that is a 13 range. That's not fun. I'm actually gonna send a tank up here. I don't need them all down here, so I can just do this. Also, you're going up there because you're not doing damage. Is anything meaningful? Something. That's 24. Okay, so one of their tanks can kill one of my tanks in 2 shots. I think it might just be out of range. I'm going to press the attack on that side. It's going to be the best shot I have. Also, I want 3 turns. I'll speed this up. Oops. Actually, you know what? Yeah, you're good. So as long as I have something in front for the assault guns to kill the tanks, I can be fine. Yeah. I'm more worried about blue though. Yeah, because they can just do that. guess I have three up there. So I've got nothing up there now, because eventual death, I guess. I know there's gonna rain down on this, so I'm gonna try to get this done, I guess. Okay, they don't have any movement. Alright. We're gonna blow that up, but to be honest, that's not the biggest concern I have. No, I need to get rid of that so I can find the rest of the mines. Because that is going to be extremely important. But I don't have those mines found, or else I'll just shoot them. I just don't see them too close, although I could be wrong about that. Alright, yeah, oh wait, never mind. Also, that was a gold one, that's why it wasn't too immediately useful. Alright, I just didn't see that. Alright. So I have gold, fuel, and more raw material. So production-wise, I'm not going to be able to do a whole lot, unless I really want to start destroying my gold refineries. Because look at that, it's 15 fuel right there, and that's 10 raw material. I almost feel like I might have to start moving stuff if I have the time. Oh, I never shot. That was entirely my bad. Alright. Okay, so yeah, they saw it. I might just make more scouts. I'll worry about the engineer later. Alright, let's get that connected right now. And then I can just get the rest of this. I really might want this. Well, that's fair, I guess, if you want to call it that. Alright, so I've got, looks like, three rocket launchers, three missile cars that have absurd range. And surveyors coming to check for mines. Bring you up here. Because I've only got 16 movement, or 16 speed, and 6 range. They can pretty much just move, sit still, and by the time I try to kill one of them, they'll just kill the rest of my assault guns because I don't have an armor upgrade. Because I might just have to lose a minimal four, put a minimal force down here. Because it looks like they're not a threat, and I need to find a way to get to them. Because they can just, like, sit still and wait for me to come to them. I feel like they're gonna push into my base really bad before I even get to stop them. Okay, so they don't have any Ecospheres points. But I'm more worried about blue. Well, that's a good sign, I guess, but it means I can spot pretty much my base. Oh yeah, they see all of that now. Minus 5 turns. Stop after that. Might as well bring it up. I need something for fodder. Yeah, they've already got everything on here. And that is something that's gonna be a little annoying. Should keep this bow back. Yeah, even this isn't doing it. This is only 7 range with even less movement. So I don't know if green has anything or what, but I might just start stripping it away. I'll just use the tank and keep it close. So the rest will go up here to try to stop them. I say that with a little less confidence because they can just outrange everything. Oh, that's still going. Alright, that was weird. I don't know why it automatically allocated to account for this not running. But I think it made it for this, but it just realized it can just adjust it. Alright, I don't see any anti-air from them. So even if I lose, you know, half my base, as long as I can, I'm just gonna search here for anything really. Because I don't know what they have for an offense or a defense or anything. Okay, so it's right over here. Oh good, they're firing on that. Even though I'm mostly here for that. Although, I probably should back my engineer up now. Because if they can shoot that, they can shoot it. Alright, you're fodder now. Actually, no, I can't even afford to do that because I need that ground attack mine more than anything right now. Wait a minute, hold on. I have two left, right? Oh, there goes that idea. Actually, wait. No, I can only do that for one turn, and that won't be enough fuel. And I don't have a fuel tank. I do have one idea, I guess, but I think they don't shoot connectors. Gotta take care of all this one threat at a time. Okay, they can't reach good. I'm not even gonna bother to try to recover that. Oh, I can just do this, I guess. And then connect that when it gets there. Yeah, it seems like green might only have that for an attacking force. Sort of funny they're attacking a power station they don't need. But, hey, that's how it works here. You can kind of rush past and hit the assault gun, but it won't kill it. Actually, it will. There we go. That should be enough space. Try at least save something. Alright, so that's been destroyed. Oh, looks like there is something back here. That'll destroy the connection I have there, but I can always get that redone. I'm gonna rush this back at 8 turns just because I need something. I feel like I actually say could say could safely do cost now. Because I'm gonna need units to pump out, and right now quantity over quality. That's gonna be the most important thing. That will set me back, though. Okay. Not seeing anything else up there. I think I might actually be good. Relatively speaking, but still good. And as for the constructor, I'm probably going to need to get another vehicle plan out. Because I'll still get this connected, I guess, I may as well. But I probably would want to get the combat stuff connected up first. The ecospheres can at least try to wait. How much is a hit vehicle plant at least? I'll need the full 60 phonic. It's done really good. Trying to explore on its own. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. I feel like I just want a radar, actually, now that I didn't really think about it. That would probably be the best option. Because right now I need more scouting to get it done. I can prepare basic turrets and stuff like that. But I'm really not sure that, like, if I could scout them first, I'll be much be able to place stuff in better positions. But I still need to connect a lot. It's gonna be thin connectors, because I'm not gonna have much time to do much else. But let's get bulldozers after the repair units. Actually, no, buildings will repair on their own anyway, so I don't need that. I will need a landing pad for this. Maybe even an AMAC after this, and then an air transport, and probably some fighters. Five scouts, three missile crawlers and rocket launchers, and no, they have another surveyor. I mostly just have these units kind of left around, because I don't know what to do with them exactly. But I think, did it skip green's turn or something? Because it says blue computer turn. I swear I never see the green computer turn. Yeah, I'm just not paying attention enough. Nine a turn, it's not bad. I'm sure I'm right here. Just going to here. do have more. I'm gonna keep playing next to it. Alright, so green is here. They just seem to end their turns quick, I think. No, never mind, okay. So they're probably producing more tanks. And they're probably producing more controllers. I will connect this up and then tell the engineer to get this mining station online because I lost the raw material one. So wait, why are they just sitting there? I mean, that's good for the stealth portion, and I appreciate that, but you could have just blown it up. More about that tank, I'll get rid of that first here. Because I don't want to move it. You know, let's actually get a fuel tank for some fuel, I guess. Oh, they do have mobile anti-air. Alright, so they are starting to get that out now. The good thing mobile anti-aircraft are like one of the worst weaknesses in the game. Okay, never mind, we have full defenses. Okay. So it is playing catch up. Not my favorite thing to do in games like that. I mean, usually catch up with like comebacks and stuff like that, you know, that's fine, but usually it's when you're kinda like you're purposely dragged down a ton, so it's not really an even playing field. I think I mentioned this before in my Cyberzone video, where it feels like you have to beat cheaters. But I guess it means you're good if you can beat a cheater, but I don't know. It feels like it muddies, you know, how good you can get. Because it feels like you're only ever going after cheaters, so then, you know what, never mind. I just think it's not the greatest way to... Like, it's fine if you do that every so often as a hard challenge, but that shouldn't be the basis of your game. I guess I'll say it like that. I am running this supply truck actually first. I'm actually running out of ammo. What's that other ground type thing? Yeah. I guess I can't fault them for finally getting around to it. Things are okay right now, I guess. Yes, I'm talking traders. Severe lot of them later. Okay, that is 12. But I can get 10 right here, but I want to be a little more safe. I'm still going to build the connector, probably right here, get Gunter up or something. Not sure what, but actually now I'll back it up. That was in a terrible spot anyway. Two Ego Spheres right on the forefront of where the enemy is going to come to attack you. You don't want to put your... I guess it's a good tip while I'm at it. You never want to put things that are that valuable where the enemy can really easily get to them. You know, it's kind of like if you're worried about burglary, you know, you don't put your TV and computer with, like, flashing neon lights saying, steal me. Because you're basically doing that if you put your Ego Spheres right at the front where everybody can see them. But I'm going to send this and start just connecting all this back here. I'll probably just get a submarine here, and then get one here too, because they'll probably start building their own shipyards. That's fine. I know I'm not gonna need that right now, but that was just there to supply the resupply the assault gun that I never needed to do in the first place. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of connectors, but it's gotta be done. Actually, that reminds me. Since you have more movement speed, you want to catch up quicker. Just, I guess I'll have it sit next to the engineer. Just kind of act as a... Well, I guess I'm a... Aside from the engineer thing, on the plus side, that got destroyed, so I can use it as a mining station. At least there's something good that came out of it. So I have something for scan. That's not a scout. Alright, I've got gold, but I don't want to spend on anything right now. Well, I will get scan for that, and then one for the radar. Actually, I know where I could put this tank. Right up here. Act as a warning for any other units. It's almost connected. That is four turns out. can upgrade the scan and speed for the infiltrator, so that definitely would be something they can do. Because if I can spot air potential units from them, like air units, and I don't understand that bug. It's like one of the most annoying things. So I guess if you add anything in production like that, it seems to revert it back. I hope that's just a visual bug. Because I feel like I've been through that before. Oh, 5 and 34. Alright, I'm gonna do that so I can get more mostly I think honestly another 2 training halls. I know that it does an awful lot. But to me that's gonna be more important than the research centers right now. It's more of a possibility rather than a definite certainty. Oh, I have 6 teams. Guess I never mind. Oops, I'm building a habitat I don't need. I'll cancel it before it's too late, I guess. I'm just gonna train. Care of that. That's gonna fill up slowly, but build a radar up there, build one down here, and probably stick one in the back. And maybe a fourth one in the center. Cost is coming along. And they've already got a tire. Yeah, that's gonna be always nice to do one. Thank you. a supply truck, but I have them out here somewhere. Okay. So I'll destroy those bridges next. Create it for zero raw material. So I'm pretty sure I saw blue have one too, so we've both got aircraft capability. Which means I definitely need fighters. No, just 3 and 18. Two and 26. Well, that's weird. It won't show it here. But I need, it's 26. So what's enough to trigger it? 28? I need 32 raw material to build something at 26 cost. I forgot how old the games were, kind of buggy like that. They definitely had a tendency to. I've got a feeling this is just going to be back and forth for a while. It's mostly just the... Two turns. 30 apparently for some air tire. Wait, hold on. It's 32. I think it's because of, other than it being a massive bug, but, there was. So, forge, so, two, so building times one is two. Times two is usually three, and times four is like four or six or something. So, I'm guessing what might be happening is that because it usually needs to build at such a high, it needs to spend so much to get to what it needs to do, that it might need a higher amount. It says it only needs 26, but because the engineer would have to use like 4 or something like that, it might. That's the only thing I can think of that would cause that. At least. Because they're going to destroy this and this will be disconnected. But I'll just send this up here and take care of it, because I can just do it right there. They'd have a better shot at doing it from here. Because it's cut it off from everywhere, but it's gonna take care of, take advantage of, yeah, messing up a little bit. I think blue is either, I think they might be going missile cruisers. Potentially, but I'm not so much worried about fixed defenses. If I can keep their fighters out of the sky, my better fighters, then I don't need to worry about. I mean, I might need some like missile launchers up here eventually. That's about the best I can do. Let's just get a storage unit. Don't have to worry about potentially. Yeah. Because that's not holding still. Alright. They'll fly their fighter in here if they even see mine. So, well, if I shoot, they'll need 24, and I think I'll still get away with it. I'll just go with the way back here. Actually, you know what? Just go on auto, it doesn't matter. I guess it's more raw material or something. I guess the only thing I know is probably the video should probably said this earlier, but if there's anything I can, I'm thinking I might just need to edit a little bit more to make these in-between moments kind of more, I want to say exciting. Because a lot of this is kind of just fluff of me trying to, you know, get to the point where I need to be, because I feel like this is going to go into like the hundreds for turns. Well, not, you know, probably maybe 100-something, so. That is why I'm going to split up into parts. This will probably just be called the beginning. So, we're not, I after that fighter, I'll probably get a after that fighter comes, I'll get a air transport to send the engineers around. So I don't have to worry about transportation as much. Alright, you're safe. Yeah, as long as you get the upgrades determined before you make something, it usually still applies. So we don't even have to do it like way beforehand. You can pretty much do it last minute. Wouldn't rely on it though, because just in case you might, you know, fall into like that sort of habit yourself where you're like last minute and then, oh, I forgot. That looks like a brand new power station, so I'll do that. I am gonna need a hangar. Just so I can hide these planes. So the infiltrators will give me a bit of an edge to hold off any of our units. Because right now, if I can get enough defenses, like with the shipyards too, I can hook up these three in the back, which are way over there. And then I'll probably have some engineers right over here in this area, behind all the rock craters. And then just spam ecospheres and habitats right here so I can reach 50 as fast as possible. So move over my entire, just go right there. Start getting disconnected. I guess one of the benefits here of losing some of the stuff is I can just get it back in little bits. Well, I can definitely try to chase this fighter off. Oh, they are getting close. Okay, that's good to know. It's only Gunch 7 range. Alright. I might be able to do some poking here. Alright, and hopefully some theft. Okay, this is before my other guy made the fighter upgrades. So let's personnel carrier. Y'all don't have to walk these guys everywhere. Alright, so looks like they are bringing up tanks to counter a potential assault. Blue is keeping quiet, and I don't like that. It's much easier to do things when your opponents are much more, I guess, overt in what they're doing. Or they're just pretty much let you know. So that's close. I gotta start saving movement because they are gonna get close here. Now, if you know you won't lose, like, ground units like this, World War II aircraft, what I like doing is make it just close. So you can see right here, it can't see me yet, but I've got a decent chunk on where they are. So this is kind of like we saw that missile call earlier, where it's more of a do or die situation. Either do something or you try to run away, and it doesn't always work out. So I want to see if that fighter might notice. Because if I can get this close right here, and just... because I have anti-air, if I can take that out, I might go... Alright, I'll send this over here. Mostly just have a couple of anti-aircraft, because it's just to ward any off. And then I'll choose upgraded fighters to take care of the rest. Okay, they are gonna get closer. It noticed. It definitely noticed. Oh boy. Alright. Give it 20 disruption, mostly connectors. Alright, that's just gonna run everywhere. Check around here and see what there is. I never upgrade the range. Oh, I didn't have the money. I thought I did. Okay, here we go. Right, so let's get another light vehicle plant over here. And send the other one over here too. Actually, no, I need to send it up there. Because that's where our mining station is. Alright, so I'm gonna leave that there. So let's send these two in here. Actually, you two. Upgrade everybody. Activate them all. Go shoot it. That's not much of a transporter, but trust me. It's something. I could just get more assault guns because that's really where my strength is here. I might need a constructor to speed things up. But mostly, I think I can just deal with assault guns. And then you just, I don't think I need skills. I think I more or less need a couple of these and then just go on with the engineers. Because mobile anti aircraft, I can. Usually all I like doing with it is put them down in a place that if you need to sort of leave behind anti, you can have the mobile anti-aircraft be like your backup anti-air until you get anti-aircraft turrets in there. Or fighters. Oh, fighters, looks like they're gonna send out some planes. Get a, honestly, a Corvette actually, and then just a couple summons. And then let's do some anti air. Let's go 30. Because I build this at 3 turns. And then ship the rest over here. Keep on using the bulldozers to farm it up. Oh, engineer, I thought it said, fighter. Send you up here for the next training hall. I tend to ignore, I guess that. It's a little more fun talking, I guess. maybe. 2 mining stations, and they're not on. That's a little odd. Alright, what can I see here? Disable that. Really high chance of disable. Fails it immediately. It reminds me of XCOM, where you can have like a really high percent chance to hit somebody. You can have like 80% and your soldier still lives the shot. And you wonder how? Well, actually I might realize I don't need that. I'll get the mining station first. Well, that's how. This game might be running off XCOM logic. Or whatever engine they used. I think it was Granny. If I'm not mistaken. Okay, so they do have. Yeah, that's Ayer's hand. The cost, like the attack range, could say 7 knights, but that cost is not 7 knights. Nothing like stopping coal production lines. Apparently, infiltrators are incompetent now. It's always the most annoying thing with infiltrators. You think everything goes good, and then one little mistake, and it's all over. And even the stealth aspect is hard. If you disable anything and anyone who pays attention for more than a turn knows you're doing it, it's a really hard thing to do. So I can't go right there, which is good to know. I might actually just go this way. Disable some surveyors and keep you around so I can load the infiltrator around. Steal the surveyors and then see if they have mines. But actually, that will be it for this little playthrough. This is kind of, I guess you could say, the beginning of this mission. I'll call this part one the beginning, probably. So Musashi is pushing up closer. They both have turrets, turret lines, and missile launchers, like, slightly deeper into their base, so you really can't get to them as much. No ecospheres yet, which is good. But I guess I can say a tip for this will be... is... don't be surprised if Blue thrashes you around a little bit. Because they'll kind of take almost every opportunity to do so. Because Blue has extended range, so you can try to use a scout to see if you might be able to pick them off with your assault guns. But that's about as far as you get. Green is much easier to deal with. Just make sure your mine layer is about as close to the ecosphere as possible, so leave it right next to it. And then just kind of do like a basic line around it. Because the tanks will usually run into it, and then you can just have a couple tanks in front with the assault guns. And a couple of assault guns in the back and just have them shoot away. And then for Blue, you kind of have to, in my opinion, it's best to know where they are. And the mines won't do too much because they'll have surveyors to scout. So you could almost say you could probably just put a couple tanks up there just to act as warning shots. And then try to connect the air units plant with the power station. The one you have to build one. I'd recommend building one, like the description says, so you can, you know, get it going faster. And then have the engineer connect that, so you can get a ground attack plane almost immediately and use that to destroy their missile crawlers and rocket launchers. And then after that, you can probably get a fighter or two because they will use air power. And then make sure also along with that to check for scouts and tanks that might be slipping through your lines. Because during this part, you did see me have that happen a couple times. So, it's definitely a tough mission to start out with. I think it's one of those things where once you take care of your initial defensive problems, you can go on the assault. Although, mostly you need to protect your ecosphere, so I wouldn't necessarily go all out unless you have to, and I'll probably be doing a defensive run on this. Because you don't have much places for raw material, so you really can't afford too much aggression. So that's why I'm, for research topics, I'd start with your cost. You're gonna need things cheaper. You don't have the most raw material in the world, and you won't be able to get any really of these other stats to be meaningful, to having a significant difference by the time you ward off the initial attack. Because at least the cost, you can shave some raw material on your other things, and that will add up over time. You know, getting one extra range or two extra hit points isn't going to do much for the rest of your base. And for the gold refinery, I would have to recommend pretty much being a little bit... it's a little hard to preempt because it really depends on what you need to do or want to do. So the best I can recommend is maybe get a little bit for anti-aircraft type things, so that you only really have to worry too much about ground. Ground attack planes get in a little higher, maybe a scout with an extra hit point, maybe, and improve your connectors, get some connectors and concrete blocks. Don't require raw material, it can be upgraded anywhere. And for mines, you would have to remove the mine and then replace it for the upgrade to apply. And as parts go on, I'll cover, you know, more navy, like what you want to do with your navy, a little bit more than the rest of the base. But that, I guess, guide I gave right there will be an introductory type thing, and I'll put that in the description when I do upload this video. So this will be part one. As always, if you guys have any feedback, please let me know through the comments or messages, so that I can be able to improve the content and, you know, make it more informative. Like I mentioned earlier, a little bit energy, because I guess some of this might be a little bit dull watching this go on. You could probably have this as just the audio of your background while you do work. So, alright, yeah, this has been Holden, and I'll see you guys later.